telephone, telephone. I detect you wanna make love.
Yeah.
I can feel you moving, you need a body banging. Should I come over there? Should I keep talking?
Oh, yeah.
I can feel you tossing, I can feel you shaking. But I'm so far away, so I keep talking. Baby girl, baby girl.
Overcome that is to become a success, and the only way you can become a success is to be a winner. Win all your fights, not to lose your fight.
He set him up now. He doesn't attack him. He doesn't attack him. He hit him. He's a flying jumper. He's a flying jump. He kicking him now.
Come on,
he's a winner. He's a winner. Brother, he's a winner. He's a winner.
If you're not gonna fight him for us, for you, me, and my son, and I will fight him myself.
Baby, it is called discipline.
No, it is called slavery, and I'm not taking it. I'm not out for it.
What kind of job do you want?
Life on the streets is the only job I know. It's the only life I know.
Thank you.
What is it? Your face looks pregnant like an overcast cloud.
It is my life. Has finally come to an end.
To an end? God forbid. My husband's life cannot come to an end. Just like that. At least not now. You will live long. You will live to your ripe old age. With grey hair, grey beards, weak knees, up to 90 years and above. What is the matter? What is it?
I'm going to be retired this week.
Please, don't say it. Not here. I don't want him to hear. Hi, Miko. You're going to be
this week. Let's manage it. They say I am now too old to be a security guard. They say a bureau change needs a strong and very healthy man that can resist armed robbers. They say I am now too old to walk. Huh?
They say.
The top managers of the company. Yeah. So they had a meeting. They asked me to come. I came. They asked me to sit down. I sat down. Then they said to me, Sarge, we are retiring you at the end of the week. And I said to them, my bosses, are you sacking me? They said, no, Sarge. We are only retiring you. It is just my retirement. We want you to go home and rest. I told them, my bosses, my only son is just 23 years old. He has just finished secondary school. And there is no money for him to further his education. He now roams the street. They said to me, you have savings. I said to them, no, I don't have savings at all. I told them that their salary is so small that it is impossible to save anything at the end of the month after paying bills. Salome, I said so many things to make them change their minds. But they just kept silent and were looking at me from their sealed lips. Their eyes spoke volumes of the word. Go!
Sarge, I will go with you. Let me go and beg them so that they can let you stay.
They will listen to you. My bosses do not listen with their ears. They listen with their noses, head high up like this, twitching like a rat. They smell you out. Hey, poor. Those people hate the smell of poor people. I'm telling you. Don't cry, you. If you cry, they will still retire me. You hear me? Don't. In fact, there's no need crying. Don't. But if I act like a man, if I do a manly thing, Maybe this retirement will pass me by.
What do you mean, man?
I will do a manly thing. But I will do a manly thing. Yes. Do it.
Best Ogara come back from Banco. You go open the gate.
Me? You go and open it yourself. Don't you see I'm an old man now?
I so complain, they complain every time. But even if they bring her, you go jump out.
Me? You are mad. Go and open the gate! Stop all of you. You chief, drop that money on the ground. Drop it on the ground and step back.
What money?
You think I don't know that you went to the bank this morning? There is 5 million naira in that briefcase. Drop it on the ground and step back
or you die.
Go. Step back!
Your hand is stupid. What's this?
Hands up before I kill you. Driver, come here. Pick this, take this briefcase, put it in the car. All of you, quickly! Quickly! Don't make any false move or I kill you one time. Come here, drop it and come here. Quickly, come back, come back. Come back. Will you run and come back here? Hands up for you. Hands up. Now, turn around all of you and lie down. Turn around and lie down. Chief, lie down. If you move, I kill you now, idiot. You want to retire me? Come and retire me. Come on, lie down. I will you be the first I kill now?
Yes, sir.
Put your face on the ground. All of you. Yo, hey! Can't open the gate. Can't open the gate. Open the gate. Quickly, open it. I say, open it quickly. Hey, come back. Lie down, I kill you, idiot. I say, move back. Come back, come back. Lie down, lie down. All of you, lie down. Hands up, all of you. Now, all of you on the ground. On the ground. You'll be the first I kill, idiot. Don't you want to retire me again? I will first retire you now. You, police, get up and watch me do it.
Sarge, you won't get away with this.
You say what? I will just finish you. Don't try me, pray. Get down, everybody.
Stop. You must find him. Look, you go over there. You go there. Please. Search the bushes. Search everywhere. He must not get away with this. We must find him.
Hello, Serge.
Hello. Are you listening? Listen very carefully. Do you know that bamboo bush along Onitsholona Road? That particular one where Mazi Digo buried his Obanje son. That particular bush, eh?
Are you alright? Why are you talking about... You are breathing so hard and talking about bamboo tree.
Keep quiet and listen to me. Listen, are you listening? I have buried money there. Do you understand? It is 5 million naira. It is for Matthew. Give it to him when he is 25 years old. That is 2 years from now. Eh? Tell him it is my blood. It is his father's blood. And he should use that money and become somebody in life.
Your blood? What are you talking about, Taj?
Bye.
Hello? Hello? My money, did we not pay him last month? How can somebody become so criminally minded?
Chief, don't worry. He will be found. If not today, tomorrow. Where will he run to? He's still in this country. He has a family. By the time we pick them up and detain them, you have no choice than to hand himself over.
Please, people should find him. We must find him.
Did you hear that sound?
It's there. Let's go.
Is he alive?
The chief is dead.
How can he be dead? Where's my money? Where's the briefcase? Search the bushes, search everywhere. How about his pocket? Somebody search. Did he find the money? Hurry up!
Yeah, take that away. Are you following me?
So, what did he, did he find anything?
Only the set, chief.
What do you mean the set? How about the money? Did he call anybody?
No last call, chief. No last call.
I can't believe this. How can people be so wicked? Please keep looking. I'll never forget this. I did everything for Serge. What did he want that I didn't give him? I gave him everything. Even took care of his family. This is wicked. He must pay for this. Serge, you pay for this. I promise you, you pay for it. You and your family will pay for this.
Madam, the police want to ask you a few more questions. You must come with us to the station.
What? That's not going to happen, though. We are still fresh in mourning. I mean, can't a woman be allowed to mourn her husband in peace?
Of course not. Not when her husband is the criminal who stole my money. And not when we're still trying to figure out what he did with the money before he died. No, nobody mourns him just yet.
I'm telling you, she's not going anywhere.
Officer, do you see that? It's like father like son. Bring him to the station as well for questioning.
You've told yourself one big lie because I'm not going anywhere with you people.
Young man, you're coming with us to the station.
Matthew, let us go with them. Let us go to the station with them. We are not criminals. If they ask us questions, we answer them. So let's go. Whatever they ask, we answer them.
Mama, I don't support following these people.
Let us go. We are not criminals.
We are coming back. Take
off
the house,
eh?
We are coming back.
Hey, what is it? I think this one. I don't touch her now. She's going.
Where do you want us to go? Are we entering this motor?
Yes.
I hope we'll come back.
We'll come back. I hope we can.
In your previous statement, madam, you told us that there was no communication between your husband and yourself after he left the house on the day he died.
Yes, I said so.
You still say so?
Yes.
How often did your father confide in you?
He did not. He kept his secrets to himself. He saw me as a small boy, even at the age of 23.
Mm-hmm. But did he confide in your mother? I mean, would you say that, judging from your observations as the only member of the family beside your parents?
My father lived a sad life because he had no money. He didn't talk too much, not even to my mother. And the only person who enjoyed his company was himself.
But your son has just told us that hardly was there any secret between you and your late husband. So, we take it that your husband must have confided with you about his plans to steal the money and run away with it. Deny this.
My son said so.
Yes, he said so.
Then he must have gone crazy as a result of sorrow. My husband will never say such a thing to anyone. He kept his inner thoughts closed, even to me.
Now, where were you on the day your father died?
At home. The policeman who came to break the news to us met me at home.
Somehow, their statement and their stories match. We questioned them this time separately, but their stories tally. I think they know nothing.
And the bush?
Nothing.
So, where's the money? Serge is dead and gone. We know he didn't spend the money.
Chief Otega, calm down. We have to follow other leads. He could have worked with a second party. Someone from your office. Yes. Come to think of it. How did he know that you went to the bank that same day? And how did he know that there is money in the briefcase? Check it, Chief.
Officer, let me tell you something you need to know. It was the end of the month. All my staff know that I have to go to the bank to get money for their salaries. So that question does not arise at all.
All the same, I think it is still a good idea for us to turn our searchlight on your workers. They must have been an accomplice. Yes.
What's in this bag?
Yam. I want to buy yam.
Okay, let me go and buy it.
No, don't worry. We still need Gary in this house. So, I'll give you money to go to Mama Kufre's kiosk and buy Gary while I boil this yam.
Okay, I'm on it now.
What you don't walk that way the time?
Leave her now. Why the Isabel put something for them? Everybody will pay, they go pay her.
You don't collect money today.
They go pay
her now. Shame on Trian. You will tell what your partner get this.
I don't come work before you. Leave this man, put something more for work. Come here,
dude. Come here, bring your
Matthew.
Ma.
It's almost 2 years since your father died.
I know.
How was your day?
Terrible as usual. Terrible.
It is now 2 years since your father died.
I know.
Come inside. I want to show you something.
Something?
A gift.
Gift.
Come. Your father's blood.
Father's blood.
Open it. Open it.
Jesus! What's this? Whose money is this, Mama?
This is what your father died for. The 5 million naira he stole from his office. He said I should give it to you 2 years after, when you'll be 25.
Your father stole money from me?
Yes. I do not want to judge him. If I do, I will condemn him. I just want to dwell on the sacrifice which he made for you, his only child. And I say to you, put this money, which is your father's blood, into good use, so that my husband's crime and death will not be in vain.
I don't know what to do with this money.
I know. But whatever you decide to do, whichever business you decide to invest in, is promise me you'll be wise. Promise.
My promise. I promise. I promise.
This one good. Eh?
This one is fresh now.
Just enter market, Oga. Oga! Oga! Oga!
What's the matter? Why is your face like this?
I don't know why some people cannot treat other people with respect. Small respect.
What happened? They didn't buy.
You saw the man now. He came, parked his car like he wanted to buy. Then I met him, asked him, Oga, do you want to buy? He wound down his glasses. Then I asked him, Oga, do you want to buy? See the bread I have for you. Only for him to just speed off like that. And he started laughing.
Huh? Matthew, what were you expecting? You're just a common roadside bread seller. You want respect? No, Matthew, I beg. You don't even own a shop, so just follow the insult.
But is it because he has a car? Eh? Is it because he has a car? Does he think I can't buy a car?
Can you buy a car?
Can I buy a car?
Can you buy a car? You know it, I know it. You can't buy a car. So why are we talking about that?
But how much is a car? Eh? Highest 3.5 million.
Can you buy a car?
If I buy a car tomorrow, what will you do?
Matthew, please leave me alone.
I'm asking you again, if I buy a car tomorrow, what will you do?
If you buy a car tomorrow?
Yes.
Sleep with me.
Huh?
Yes. You've been disturbing me that you want to date me, and I said no. So if you... I know that you can buy a car tomorrow. If you can buy a car tomorrow. I won't only say yes. I'll date you. But with the way you are going, okay, Lily, you can buy a car.
Oh, no, wait, darling. Boy, I don't need to go
out. Mama! He just got it!
I thought you spent today to think about how best to invest the money your father left for you. How come you went to hawk bread again on the road?
Mama.
Don't you have dreams? Don't you want more from life?
Mama. Making up my mind won't be easy. Deciding what I want to do with the money won't be easy either. It's a big responsibility. I'm only taking my time. And while I'm taking my time, I know what to do than to be idle.
You're right. You're right. Very, very right. Take your time. I know you're a man old enough to take wise decisions. Huh? But in case you need my candid advice, don't hesitate to ask for it. We don't want to drink your water from the top one.
No,
it's okay.
No, I finished.
Gala! Gala! I got to
Gala!
Gala!
Gala! Gala!
Yes, my dear. This is my girl.
No, come in, come in.
Come in.
Matthew.
Come inside. This is my car now, huh?
Matthew.
You haven't seen a ghost, huh? You've not seen a ghost, it's me.
How did you get it?
You asked too many questions, right? Come, let me give you a good
question.
I said, leave this nonsense alone. What is this? Say bye-bye to this, huh? Let me give you a good life. What's your problem?
You just carry smoke.
I said, leave this. Come here. Get into the car.
Matthew.
I said, get into this car. Let me give you a good life. Yeah.
My slippers, my slippers.
This cheap thing. Okay. Alright. Is that you have something to wear? Hey, how are
you? I want to be that.
How are you? How are you? How are you?
We're not very sure.
Anything for us at
the party. Okay.
Matthew.
Alright. Shamona, hold this one.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Take my gala.
No okay, problem. Okay. I'll do it.
I don't want to go with you. Yeah.
What?
Hurry up.
Take my gala.
You kept your promise, huh? You've done your own bit, so it's time for me to do mine. So tell me, what do you want?
What do I want?
Yes, what do you want? Because there's money right now.
Look at what you're wearing. You're looking good. Look at what I'm wearing. Why can't you buy me new clothes? They're not mine.
Is that your problem?
Yes.
See, there's money now, huh? Take care of it. Matthew has money. Alright?
I love you.
I love you. Let's go. 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 I don't promise my mama, so now you are going to marry. Thank you so much. Do you like them?
Of course. I love them. I love them so much. I can't wait to begin to kiss you and get to meet up.
I've been waiting for them.
I should now. I'll block you. I'll block you.
Yeah,
thank you.
It's alright. It's alright. Take care of you. There's no problem.
I love you.
I love you too.
I really love you.
I love you more. Yes, let's enjoy our lives together.
Life is meant to be enjoyed.
No, you know. No problem, I'll take you on.
Life is beautiful.
Yes.
Hey.
I can't sleep. It's now I feel it. You said I need no worry. You're the faithful one.
Auntie, I'm leaving.
Olivia! Come back, Olivia!
And where are you taking me? I'm going out with my friend.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Go right inside.
And remove these things you're wearing. So that you go and hawk bread. Go and hawk bread, though, because this house will not contain both of us. Go and hawk bread.
No. Auntie, you said I do.
I am not going to hawk anything. Then you look for a house to live.
Is it because I did it just to make you happy? Auntie, I'm not hawking, though. Do you see girls that are pretty like me hawking bread?
This girl has grown, so she needs...
Hawking gala, hawking everything. I'm not hawking, I'm going now. Olivia, come here! Auntie, me, I don't
come here. Come!
I'm going out with my friend.
Come back here! Olivia, come back!
Auntie, me, I don't want
to... Olivia! Come back, Olivia! She did you!
Come, young man! So you are the young man that
has deceived my sister!
Huh? Come here, Olivia!
Auntie!
Come on! Auntie! Where do you think that you're going?
Hey!
Come on, come down!
Auntie!
Olivia! Come down from that car!
Auntie,
come down!
Auntie!
Come down! Yeah, come down! Come on, come down! Come down!
How much?
22,000.
Yes, sir. What we've had since morning, eh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Go dismissed.
Daddy.
Yes, sir.
Can you count it for you?
Yes, sir. Yeah, that's
100,000 naira there, giving me 50,000.
I love my daddy.
52,000, eh?
I love my daddy.
After she gives you that money, huh?
Yes, sir.
Crazy, right?
Yes, sir. I love my daddy.
I love you.
I love you, daddy.
Yeah.
I love you.
Just fits so right. All your problems, girl, I'll share. Because you really know it's obvious that I care.
You know what, girl.
Your boo and your honey, your lover every morning. Your midnight lover, your sweet love talker.
Of this nice man.
No, Oga, you have to increase the money you give me for parking your car here every day. Sometimes our guests can't even find enough parking spaces for their cars. Okay, the other day the manager asked me who owns this particular vehicle, and I lied to him. I told him that it is being owned by one of our guests in the hotel. All that lie for you. You have to pay me more money.
Ishmael, you don't have to be greedy now. At least I give you 2,000 naira every day. What's your problem?
Oga Matthew, it's either you increase the money to 3,000 naira per day or you find somewhere else to go and park your car from today. I don't talk my own phone.
Okay, okay, wait. Open the door.
Better.
I've been waiting anxiously for your return. See, I ran into an old boy of my secondary school today. He makes Dubai visa for people. Yes, and he's also into gold business. And then we talked. And then he can make Dubai visa for you in 1 week. Then you can start the gold business with him. See. With 3 million naira, you can make your first trip. And then, you just start the business like that and it will grow. It will continue to grow. And then, you still have to rent a bug shop with the remaining money. I still have a lot of balance for us to change and get a better accommodation. Can we be excited?
I need to talk for outside. Please,
let's go inside. I know now.
let me show you how excited I am. Eh? At least that money doesn't have to lie in the bank idle where you kept it. Eh? While you go out every day with your ears on the ground, scouting for what business to invest in. Tell me you're excited.
Mama, stop this thing now. Please, let's go inside before the neighbors hear that we have money that we kept away.
That rubbish from you. I will not take it from you or anybody. Nonsense. One room, but I'm proud of it.
Yes, hello. Okay, I'm coming now, eh? I'm coming.
What is it?
Mama, I just have to move. Well, here's 250,000 naira for her accommodation and feeding for 2 weeks, eh?
My love.
Yes,
I hope you're not going to leave me here all by myself. I mean, if you find time to, you know, spend a couple of minutes with me, hours, days, weeks.
Of course, you know I won't.
Say it.
Hey, hey. Let me be there.
Thank you.
How are you?
Fine.
Come inside, Rain.
You know, this is a very good time. You know, I need this really when I have to be in my business.
Okay. Matthew, there's a problem. Or...
What problem?
Wait. Ismail.
Where's my car?
Ismail wanted to go and post for his girlfriend. So he took your car to her house.
Huh?
And on his way back, he has a terrible accident.
Where's my car, my friend?
It's even a miracle for him to have survived.
Eh? Okay. Where's my car? Eh? Forget about Ismail. Where's my car?
Okay, when I saw the car this morning, I couldn't believe anybody could survive that accident from that car.
It's true. My own car wrecked.
Yes.
Eh? My car?
Yes. You can go and see for yourself. At the red level room.
Okay, forget about Ismail. Where's my car?
The car is destroyed. It's completely wrecked.
Huh?
Yes, I got my key.
Hey!
Okay, see. You can't repair that car. Nobody can repair that car unless you are willing to pay double for the amount who bought that car. To be frank. Okay. Go to the red.
Hey!
The red level room and see for yourself.
Hey!
What do they say?
That's the one over there. They say he hit a truck at breakneck speed. If he survives, he won't walk again.
Hey!
Money for the Dubai visa. Did you go to bank to the bank yet? Eh?
There's no bank to go to. I didn't go to the bank.
What is the matter?
In fact, I don't have a bank account. I lied.
You lied?
Yes. I used 3.5 million naira to buy a car. I wanted to have small fun and later sell the car and, you know, start business. But right now, the car is damaged beyond repair. Somebody had an accident with it. The remaining 1.5 billion naira, I don't know what I did with it. I was shopping and having a nice time. Right now, I think it's about 40,000 naira remaining.
Well, what kind of joke is that? Why are you pulling my legs? Why?
Mama, wait.
Hey. Let it not be too
Mama, this is what is remaining from the money.
Tell me it's a lie. Tell me I'm dreaming.
Mama, it's not a lie. It's not a lie. Do you even blame me? Do you blame me? I mean, have I seen this kind of money before? How do I handle it now? Did your papa prepare me for this kind of thing? I saw big money. I went crazy for a while, only to get broke again.
Oh, prodigal son. Prodigal son. Prodigal son! Is this what your father died for? Is this what your father died for? Hey, prodigal son!
Mama, leave me.
I am going to curse you for this. Prodigal son! I am going to curse you for this.
Mama, leave me alone.
Your children will do the same thing to
mama,
you.
Mama, leave me alone.
Your children will do the same
thing to you. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. What was it? Leave me. If I'm a prodigal son, what about papa? Did you see money? Were you expecting anything good to come out from it? What about you? Are you not a thief too? You kept stolen money and gave it to me. Doesn't that make you too a thief? Are you not a thief?
You go inside the house.
Take your things and leave.
I'll shout to.
Neighbors! 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 Come! My father was a thief.
Go
I'll
ahead.
Tell everybody my father stole money. Leave me alone.
Let's go.
Leave me alone.
My brother stole.
See, my father stole money. Yes, my father stole 5 million naira from his oga and gave to this woman to give me to do business. Now the money spent and she's crying now. Eh? See, tell your mother my father was a thief. Yes, and she's also a thief. She gave her son stolen money to do business. This is what is remaining. Now she's annoyed. What is this? See, I don't want anything from your house, so.
Tibor!
How many 35-year-olds are still being fed and clothed by their parents? How many? You are a prodigal son. What's that? Are you not ashamed of
yourself? If I'm a prodigal son, then Papa is a prodigal father. You two, you're a prodigal mother. Mama, leave me alone.
It's okay now.
Leave me alone. What's it? See, I don't want anything from this your house. So take this your useless one-bedroom house.
Wow.
Where? Since I was born, I've never known anything but hardship and suffering.
Go!
You're making
noise. Go out there!
I will go. If you see me in this house, call me an idiot. If you see me in this house, call me a prodigal son.
Go!
Prodigal mother. Leave me alone!
Prodigal son! Go!
Prodigal mother, leave me alone!
What
is it?
I'm going! What's
Mama, too sorry now. You can't kill yourself because of this thing now. So I stand up.
My heart is bleeding.
Let's go inside now.
My heart is bleeding.
Come on, please don't kill yourself. Sorry.
No.
Sorry, come on.
Come
now, stand up.
I'm going.
Go and call him back for me.
I'm going. Let me go. Calm. Put down money. This money can even get somewhere better than this rubbish house.
What am I living for? Tell him that I want to see this.
Stand up now. You can't even see yourself.
Matthew has killed me.
Stand up now.
Yes.
Are you lodging here alone?
No, I'm lodging with my boyfriend. Why do you ask?
I would like you to come stay with me in my room.
Is that why you stopped me?
Yeah. I believe your boyfriend doesn't deserve you by keeping you here alone. I would rather ask if you're genuinely in love with him.
Of what business of yours is it if my boyfriend loves me or not? Please, I don't want any trouble.
Who is this man?
I don't know him, mom. Somebody I just saw here now.
Somebody just met him. So, I use my money to put you in this hotel only for you to flirt around, eh?
I don't know him. I just saw him here in this hotel.
You saw me here in this hotel. I use my father's money to shop for you. Buy me watches for you. Everything, expensive clothes, and you're here flirting with men. You're flirting with men with my father's money. My father used to be somebody. My father's money, you're flirting with it. You're flirting with my father's money.
Check the girl. The girl has passed out. Call the police. Hurry! Call the police.
Please kill the girl.
She's dead.
Olivia,
that's how it happened. He beat me.
He was choking me, holding my neck, choking me.
Before I knew what was happening, I woke up in the hospital. They said I passed out, that's how he had beaten me up. When I asked the police, they said police had arrested him.
So I'm back to square one.
Yeah. Sorry.
Hey!
That's not the end of your life.
My sister, let me go and send my Dala.
You are here now?
I'm here.
Dala!